You receive an order for 5 milliunits per minute. The solution is labeled 10 units per liter. What is the correct flow rate in milliliters per hour? So to find the correct flow rate, we'll have to perform several conversions. Notice how the order is given in milliunits per minute. The solution is given as units per liter, and the flow rate is mils per hour. We'll solve this problem using proportions. Let's begin by converting the given order in milliunits per minute to milliunits per hour. But to set up the proportion, we'll compare milliunits to minutes. So we'll begin with the rate of 5 milliunits per minute. So 5 milliunits per 1 minute must be equal to the number of milliunits per hour. So we have an unknown number of milliunits, we'll call it x milliunits, per 1 hour. But because we know we have to have the same units on the top and the same units on the bottom, instead of writing 1 hour here, since 1 hour equals 60 minutes, write this as 60 minutes. So if we find x, we'll know the number of milliunits per hour. Again, it's important to recognize that we have the same units on the top and the same units on the bottom. If we didn't have this, we'd have to perform a conversion first. So here we have 1 times x must equal 5 times 60. Well, 1 times x is x, 5 times 60 is 300, which means the given order could also be written as 300 milliunits per hour. Now for the next step, let's determine how many units we need per hour. So we'll set up another proportion. 300 milliunits is to an unknown number of units, we'll call it y units, must be equal to the conversion between milliunits and units is given here, 1,000 milliunits equals 1 unit. This will give us the second half of the proportion. 1,000 milliunits is to 1 unit. Again, notice how we have the same units on the top and the same units on the bottom. So now we can cross multiply and solve for y. So we have y times 1,000, or 1,000y, must equal 300 times 1, or 300. Divide both sides by 1,000. 300 divided by 1,000 is equal to 3/10, or 0.3. Which means now we could say that the order is 0.3 units per hour. So now the last step is to determine how many milliliters we need per hour. So we'll set up a third proportion. 0.3 units per an unknown number of milliliters, we'll call it z milliliters, must be equal to the solution rate of 10 units per 1 liter. But again, notice how we have milliliters in the denominator here. So we also want milliliters here. So instead of writing 1 liter, we'll use the conversion that 1 liter equals 1,000 milliliters. So we have 1,000 milliliters here. And now that we do have the same units on the top and on the bottom, we can finally cross multiply and solve for z, which will tell us the number of milliliters we need for this order, and therefore the number of milliliters needed per hour. So we have z times 10, that's 10z, must equal 0.3 times 1,000, that would be 300. Dividing both sides by 10, we have z equals 30, which means if the order is 0.3 units per hour, that means the order requires 30 milliliters per hour. I hope you found this explanation helpful.